The Origin of Species by Darwin is an act of science communication. It was the prose, metaphors, analogies, that's precisely what started the field. Over 150 years later, now somehow if you do that kind of work, you're not a scientist. Doesn't make any sense to me. Science has always been driven by communicators. My name is Brandon Ogbunu. I'm a computational biologist who studies disease dynamics, and that includes everything from how drug resistance evolves at the molecular level to the sorts of social forces that impact how epidemics happen, and how do scientific ideas influence the world that we're in. Science is the greatest knowledge creation force the universe has ever seen, but it must be packaged in a manner that everyone can appreciate. You look at the world full of ideas, you look at film, you look at sport, people love them because they're accessible. And those are all deeply sophisticated things. But there's something about those experiences that people latch onto. And I want science to be that same sort of thing. For me, scientists were few and far between, right, as a young person. One thing I remember having a big impact on me, it was a 1988 essay by Stephen Jay Gould called Streak of Streaks about Joe DiMaggio, the famous New York Yankees 56-game hitting streak. And he gave kind of this scientific lens on this popular culture phenomenon. And when I read that when I was young, I was like, whoa, who is this person that's able to think about cultural phenomena in a really, really intelligent way and yet color it with this sophisticated science? So I looked him up and he was a professor. An evolutionary biologist, no less. And it had a very, very big impact on me because it demonstrated to me that you can take scientific ideas, you can package them in thoughtful and creative ways, and you can reach audiences that maybe, you know, you didn't think you were reaching. So I look at a lot of my work in this realm as paying it forward.
Brandon Ogbunu, he's being acknowledged for his...
To take the work that I'm doing, to construct it in a way such that everyone has access to it.
Intersection of science, culture, and... society.
And I think in contemporary times, this is even more important. The act of getting people to appreciate this knowledge creation tool called science, I think it's the Manhattan Project of our time. I think not only does the survival of science depend on this, but doing better science depends on this.